nobody can be late. We will have the local police enforcing that also. Like last time, they killed a police officer over there.
Sorry, what did you say happened last time?
They killed a cop. Yeah.
Along with the police escort, undercover agents are embedded amongst the team.
Hands on guns.
Are ready?
Ready.
They're all standing with their hands on the guns, hey?
Yeah.
I hope they can get a gun out of a holster faster than getting in the car.
Go, go, go.
Yeah.
Do I need a machete?
Probably one of the most aggressive places I've ever been in my life.
They said that the road's pretty dangerous getting up there, hey?
It is.
Did they mean dangerous as in, like, it's huge cliffs, drops and things like that, or people dangerous?
Both. Mostly people dangerous. There's a couple of dead roads that appear out of nowhere in the main road.
Okay.
When usually the bandits intercept people and...
Bandits?
Yeah.
Banditos.
Turn around.
So I was really anxious about Rinconada. It was obviously really hard to see and it was very confronting.
Rinconada is like nothing I've ever seen. It's a nightmare. Full of people that are trying to earn a crust and finding those tiny little bits of gold just to survive.
The police said that someone goes missing every single day here.
Yeah. What?
Every single day there's a missing person report.
This is a terrible place. Just from like a human and an environmental standpoint, it felt a bit like hell seems too harsh, but near there.
Did you see all the mercury in there?
Whoa.
This is environmentally, like, horrific.
Is it?
Oh, yeah. At the same time I say that, like, I'm actually really impressed with the people in Rinconada. They're living at 17,000 feet on the side of a glacier, blowing shit up underground with no ventilation. If anything goes wrong, you're dead. And I'm guessing that's a common occurrence.
The mining is insane.
Parker, they want to show us the gold they have.
Ah.
But the gold is enormous.
Oh, look.
Each year, almost 80,000 ounces are extracted, worth $131 million.
The amount of gold that's come out of that mountain is insane.
So wild.
It's exciting to see potential like that, but at the same time, from like a human and an environmental standpoint, like, I don't think so.
Would you ever mine in Rinconada?
Oh, there's no way. There's absolutely no way. Hard pass.
In Ghanai, Parker is the only member of the team able to continue.
One of the biggest highlights for me was seeing the dredges and getting to run the 1100, which is a 110-ton machine.
The 1100 excavator is the biggest machine Parker has ever operated.
I'm definitely over the moon right now. I know half the crew's out sick, maybe a little bit selfish, but we're here to find gold. And this is really cool. I can't believe they're letting me do this. I would never let some stranger, so even if I watched them on TV, well, I don't know. Maybe. Like, you know, Matthew McConaughey showed up at my mine site, I'd probably let him do anything he wanted, but for the most part, this is nuts.
Like, you know, almost a 250,000-pound excavator on a barge feeding a wash plant on another barge.
This is the weirdest thing I think I've ever done. Just never even thought that this was a thing that was possible.
Like, that's very cool.
Can you tell them that was one of the coolest things I've ever done? They're making money in the middle of nowhere because they're mining smart. We've done a lot of shit on these trips, but like, I don't think anything compares to this. This takes the cake.
This pan is going to determine how our trip goes, Parker.
After 8 weeks and over 1,900 miles of travel.
No gold.
So we should keep looking.
Parker finds a potential investment opportunity.
Oh, yeah. There we go. Oh, look, it's beautiful gold.
7 hours of processing that ground.
So it's like an ounce per 100 yards. That's very cool.
Following 2 months on the road, on the eve of making his final decision, it's time for Parker to take stock.
I'd like to think that Cancio is a good guy that's honest. And it wouldn't be money down the toilet.
If you don't risk, you don't win.
It's the time and the place for some money to be put down.
What I want to propose is just like, it's very simple. I'd like to put up $25,000. So does he want to do it?
Isn't he?
But before Parker can seal the deal.
He's worried about not knowing how far this could go.
Well, then we should probably boot all these cameras out of here or go somewhere more private.
He has to earn Cancio's trust.
I don't know if you're listening, but I have no idea where this is going.
First, he's saying that they have been really excited about having you here, but they also know that you're deadly serious when you do something.
Of course.
Because they have been following you on the TV for years already. So this is his reality. He's trying to make a living, and they work only with people they trust, like family and friends.
Yeah.
So they want to know if all the people here is people they can trust.
Yeah. 100%. Now, and the last thing that any of us want that are here, both, you know, us and the film crew, the last thing any of us want is to have any sort of negative impact on the way that they make a living.
Lo último que queremos nosotros es traerles problemas y generarles algún tipo de impacto negativo en su forma de vivir.
It's basically like he's gambling in that hole and I want to gamble with him.
Porque al final lo que dices es tú medio que estás apostando por él.
And I want it to be filmed if he's all right with that.
¿Está bien que la damos en la mesa en la cámara?
¿Eh?
Sí. Thank you.
Gracias.
No hay muy bien.
What's happening?
Hello.
We just talked about life on TV and not letting it screw up your family and stuff like that. Something I'm not very good at. We didn't talk about any deals.
You didn't?
We're gonna do that now. So, does he want to do it?
Isn't he?
Obvio.
Sounds like a deal.
¿Hay un trato entonces?
Sí.
Perfecto.
Perfecto. It's a beautiful coincidence that at the end of the trip we found a really good ground to mine. So that's like the golden seal for the end of the trip, right?
Gracias, Parker.
Gracias.
We've achieved every single goal, and it's been a relentless roller coaster of emotion and pain sometimes and fun, and that always adds up to a really cool trip.
I'm excited.
Te emocionado.
I'm so curious what's down there.
Imagínate nosotros. Está curioso de lo que hay abajo. Quieres saber qué hay abajo. El oro.
We go on these trails around the world to try and find places that are untapped. We tried to do that in Alaska and we failed. And I think Tapiza could be that next place.
Ya va a haber sorpresas.
There's gonna be sorpresas.